Bola. Can everyone say bola? Oh, come on, you can do it better than that. Bola! All right, one more time. Bola! Right. Hello everyone, my name is Joseph Wivakau. I'm from Matavai Cultural Arts Center. I'm one of the tutors there teaching the Fijian Meke class there. And on behalf of Mary Jane McKibben-Schwenke and Freddie, I would like to we'd like to congratulate everybody, and obviously happy Fiji Day to everybody. And today we're going to present to you a few items. As you know, Fiji is a multicultural place. We've got Indians, Fijians, Samoans, Tongans, Cook Islands, and even Hawaiians. And so you're going to see a few of the items presented here today. You're going to see a bit of that today. So I hope you enjoy the show. Are you guys ready? I said, are you ready? All right. We'll just introduce Mary Jane. Ladies and gentlemen, please give up for the director of Matavai Cultural Arts Center.
Hello. Talo Falava, Wulawinaka. Welcome along to this great day. It's wonderful. God really brought the sunshine out for us today for the community of Minso and, of course, our Fijian brothers and sisters. As JJ said, we have a cultural arts center, Pacific Cultural Arts Center in Liverpool, where we teach young kids from as young as 2 all the way up to 63 or whatever their body, if their body can make them do the dancing up to 70, then it will go as far as that. But we teach Samoan, Hawaiian, Cook Island, Fijian Meke, and Tongan, Tawalunga, and hopefully for next year we'll have the Niuean culture joining us, and eventually we would like to have a massive center where people can come and enjoy our Pacific hospitality and our culture as well. To the first island, and of course the most important island for today, we're going to take you to Fiji with this number called Bula Malayu. Kids Pacific dance, it's not just about the movement. It's about where it comes from. It's about what makes our parents who they are today. Our kids in Australia are faced with different cultures every day. Matavai Cultural Art is about a place that belongs to Pacific kids where they can come and be themselves and learn about the depth and the intelligence and the greatness of our ancestors. Taking you now to a place with 15 beautiful islands. It's one of the paradises of the world. We're going to take you now to the place where they say Kia Orana, the Cook Islands. Here are the students from our Cook Islands team. Falava, very good. Okay, now every Monday night and Saturday, Monday around 7:30 and on Saturday at 4:30, we have a Hawaiian kahiko class. And it's taught by a guy named Jason, who's from the Campbelltown area. And he also learned the kahiko in Hawaii. So he teaches a Hawaiian class. And bringing up for you next is the group from the Hawaiian class. Girls? Aloha!
Thank you. Aloha!
Together for Lyric and Daniel doing the Siva Afi. Siva Afi, our youngest student, is 4, and we also teach adults. That class is every Wednesday night and Saturday. And obviously they don't start with fire straight away. These boys have been dancing for about 2 years, and they're currently training to go to the World Champs in Hawaii. So at Matavai, we're all about trying to offer services that will be able to help our kids, and opportunities where they can travel somewhere as well to show off the skills that they're learning at Matavai Cultural Arts. Now in the islands, much of us might think that the islands is just about beautiful sunny skies and blue seas and beautiful brown skinned girls that sway their hips and men that are masculine and warriors. But we're so much more than that. Our ancestors went through so much so that we could be standing on this very ground in Australia. Our ancestors who kept cultures alive for thousands of years. And I often question why in Australian schools do they not teach Pacific history when it's right in our back door. Pacific history, I'll tell you a little about where I'm from in Samoa. We had a movement called the Mau Movement. At one point in time, Samoans were overrun by New Zealand, Germans, British, who were all trying to colonize Samoa, much like they did in your islands. Samoans were known as the first people to gain independence. But they also had big brothers and cousins, the Fijians, to look at. When I read and studied, Fijians were known for warriors. They wouldn't allow the white explorers near their shores. And Samoa took that leaf out of the Fijian book. So they fought for their sovereignty in a very peaceful way. There was a movement one day, and today they know it as Black Saturday, where Samoans march peacefully to ask for the New Zealanders to let them have their country back. It was supposed to be peaceful, but little did this movement know that sitting up in the balconies were New Zealand police ready to shoot them. So as our leader, Tamasese, put his hands up to calm the crowds, he was shot dead in front of his people. 9 other people were also shot dead that day. And that is why it's called Black Saturday. This next Siva from Samoa is to pay homage and tribute to our ancestors that fought so hard to keep our culture alive. And for us, it is our job and duty to pass it on to our children. Ladies and gentlemen, the children from the Samoan class, for performing for you, Tamasese.
Thank you.
did a good job considering there was a lot of bendizos. And I would like to bring on board all of our kids dancing. If you'd like to know any more information about Matavai, please just come and ask us in the back. We'd love to see you visit our center. We have a lot of interesting things that go on there, and we never stop. It's all about the children. As you can see, we have a two-year-old playing the drums, so even though it was a little bit off, he still wanted to do it. But that's what it's all about. It's the only way they're going to learn. I'm sure they have that opportunity in the island, so at Matavai, we try and offer that for them. So we just wanted to all say goodbye. Thank you, Fiji, for being the country in the Pacific that all other smaller islands look up to. When I was living in Samoa, Fiji was the one that we always looked to for help, and we'd go to celebrate Hibiscus Festival. I just wanted to say on behalf of the Pacific, thank you, Fiji. And I hope there's many more awesome Fiji days like this where we all can come together and celebrate the unique cultures of the Pacific. Thank you to the organizers. All right, wave. Hello.